Father, we give you glory. We give you honor. God, we give you praise. God, we thank you for your presence and your power that's in this place right now, God. God, I thank you for your anointing that rests in this sanctuary right now, God. The Lord, I just pray right now as we continue to go forth in worship and in the word, God, that you would have your way in this place, God. I pray that as this word goes forth, oh God, it would bless somebody, God. It would help to make them better. It would help to make them stronger. It would help to make them more mature, God. And now we thank you and we praise you in advance that the word of God that is going to go forth today is going to change the lives of your people. It's going to build our faith up, God, and we're going to experience abundance in every area of our lives. We thank you and we praise you right now, and it's in Jesus' mighty name, the exalted Christ, we pray. And the people of God said amen. Amen. Can you just clap your hands and give God praise one more time? Amen. 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 Why don't y'all take about 30 seconds just to greet the people who are around you and just show them some love today before you take your seats. Amen. We're just so glad to see everybody here today. Let's do that at this time. Amen. 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 All right, I hear a little hissing in these speakers, and we can take care of that. I don't know what that is. All right, hey, how you doing? All right. All right. Amen. Amen. So awesome. So glad. It's always good just to take some time just to fellowship with one another. Amen. I hear some hissing or something over in those speakers. And if I can just get my mic turned up just a tad bit, I think we'll be good to go. Amen. I don't know if it's yeah, there we go. That took care of it. Amen. Amen. Today, we're going to continue in our series steps. Uh-oh. I think I might have a little too much high end in my mic if we can take care of that. All right, today we're going to continue in our series, that's good right there, on steps towards spiritual maturity. That's what we're talking about today. Before I move any further, I just want to take this time and introduce to the church a young man who's going to be stepping in and helping us periodically in our praise and worship. That's Brother Jamal Johnson. Hey, y'all, can y'all give him a hand just to give him a great AFFC welcome? And thank you so much, man, for just coming in and just, you know, man, just the worship, man, just that atmosphere, just setting the atmosphere, man. That's what we like, man. That's what we like, you know, because I'm before I was a pastor, I was a minister of music, worship leader. So that's right up my alley. Amen. And Doc, you make it easy for me to get up here and do what I got to do. I appreciate that. I should have used you last Sunday before the business meeting. Amen. That's all right. Y'all get that on the way when you get to the Beltway. Amen. All right. All right. Steps towards spiritual maturity. That's what we're talking about. This is a series that we're in, and today I'm going to come from 1 John chapter 5. 1 John chapter 5, and it's two verses I'm going to read there. As you all are turning there, as you know, we've been in this series since first of the year, since the second Sunday of this past month in January, and if the Lord says the same, this will probably be our last message on prayer, because we're going to go deeper and deeper into these series of messages that God has given us to share with you today. And if you were not with us over the last few weeks, you of course can go back to the YouTube channel and catch the first couple of messages that we ministered on, because the first we talked about how we should pray with persistence and passion, and then a couple of weeks ago we talked about how we should pray about everything, pray with a spirit of thanksgiving, and pray specifically. But today I'm going to kind of go deeper into this thing here, amen, and we're going to talk about asking, when we're praying, how we ask God for something. And I want to read these verses here in 1 John chapter 5, and I'm going to read verses 14 through 15. This is the New King James Version, and it says, "Now this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. And if we know that he hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we have asked of him. Now, here in this particular text that I just read, we see that John emphasizes the confidence we can have in our prayer life. And one of the greatest blessings of having salvation and eternal life is confidence in prayer, which is an assurance, rather, that our prayers are being heard. And John has used this term confidence 3 times already in this book. You'll see it in chapter 2 and verse 28. You'll see it in chapter 3, verse 21. And you'll also see it in chapter 4, verse 17. And confidence is contrasted with uncertainty or shame. Again, that is the opposite. When we talk about confidence, if you want to talk about the opposite of confidence, we're talking, it deals with uncertainty or shame. But what John is advocating here is that he's saying that living and praying in such a way that we should live, rather, and pray in such a way that we never have to be ashamed in God's presence. That's what John is telling us here. We never, when we go before God, when we go before God in prayer, when we seek him, when we ask of him, we ought to do it with a boldness. We ought to do it with confidence. And this is what John is referring to, because when we get into the presence of Almighty God, first of all, he already knows us. He already knows where we are. He already knows our situation. He already knows the things that we've had to deal with. He already knows who we don't like. He already knows who we had to cuss out last week. He already knows who we had to go off on the other day. So there's no need in being ashamed.
Yes, sir.
Amen. There's no need in being ashamed. But when we go before God, John is saying here in this text that we should go before God in confidence. Can you say amen? So there's a key. There's a key that I want to enlighten you on today as we talk about going to God and asking in confidence. And if you're going to ask in confidence, there are 3 things that you need to do. And y'all, I'm not going to be long today. I'm going to try not to be. All right. So y'all just bear with me. Amen. Now, first of all, we have to ask according to his will. That's the first thing we have to do. We have to ask according to his will. The key to confidence is asking for things that are compatible with his will. Let me say it again. The key to confidence in prayer, when we talk about the key to confidence, the key is asking in accordance to the will of God. Now, let's take a moment and think about what the will of God is for us and how we should have a comprehensible experience with the will of God. First of all, the expression "the will of God" refers to the revealed will of God. Let me say it again. The expression, when you hear the expression "the will of God," it refers to the revealed will of God. And sometimes the will of God refers to the things that God has told us he will do. So when I pray, if I'm going to pray in confidence, I have to make sure that I am asking in accordance to God's will. Because there might be things in our lives we might be praying for that might not necessarily be in the will of God.
Yeah. That's good.
Let me give y'all an example. First of all, I cannot pray, and again, this hypothetical situation, y'all. Okay, y'all know I like giving examples. All right. I cannot pray, "Lord, give me Brother Ely's wife," because that's not in God's will. Because God will for Cherie Hill Ely to be Marcus Ely's wife. Can you say amen? Amen. And then and if I turn that around, Brother Ely cannot pray and ask God to give LaToya to him to be his wife. That's not God's will. God willed for LaToya to be my wife. Can you say amen? So you got to remember that. Another thing, I can't say, "God, give me Brother Kevin Holiday's house." Amen. That's the house that God blessed Brother Kevin Holiday with. Amen. So I have to make sure that when I'm praying, because you can pray all day long about something and it might not necessarily be in God's will. You can pray you can just pray, fast, fall out, speak in tongues, pray in the Holy Ghost, all that. You can do all of that. But if it's not in God's will, you are not going to receive it. And you can be as bold and confident as you want to trying to receive it. But guess what? It's not not going to happen. Why? Because it's not aligned with the will of God. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Amen. There has to be an alignment. There has to be an alignment with our prayers and God's will. Can you say amen? Amen. So I got to pray the will of God, because God, he has a, and I told y'all a couple of weeks ago, he has a plan and a purpose for each and every one of our lives.
Yes, sir.
He has a specific assignment for each and every one of us. My assignment is to be a husband to, first of all, my first assignment is to my family, to be a husband to my wife and a father to my two children. That is my assignment in life. Now, my assignment in ministry is to be the pastor and overseer of Abundant Faith Fellowship Church. Amen. I'm not assigned to Fountain of Praise. I'm not assigned to Christ Temple of Deliverance down the street. I'm not assigned to Missouri City Baptist. I'm assigned to Abundant Faith Fellowship Church. So anything I'm praying as far as ministry related should all fall back on Abundant Faith Fellowship Church. I shouldn't be praying for another man's pulpit. Can you say amen? Why? Because that's not in God's will. God's will is for me to be standing right here where I'm standing right now and pastoring the people who I'm pastoring right now. Can you say amen?
Amen.
So I got to pray according to the will of God. But not only that, but watch this. When I ask God, when I go to him in prayer, I need to ask according to his word.
Yeah.
To his word. Ask according to his word. Meditate on scripture with a view towards prayer. If you look at John chapter 15 verse 7, it says, if this is Jesus speaking, he says, if you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire and it shall be done for you. So if Jesus' words drench our hearts and minds, we will ask for things that are according to his will. And if we keep this in mind, we will pray differently than we would otherwise. So I not only ask according to God's will, but I got to ask according to his word. You know, I remember years ago when we were doing prayer and fasting in our church that we came out of, one of the main things our bishop told us is that as you're praying, when you pray, we had prayer assignments every night. Every night we prayed for 20 days straight, praying and fasting. We had prayer assignments, Jamal. And one of them, and one night, each night really, the pastor would get up and he would say, okay, our prayer focus is going to be on this particular thing. And he would go through the scriptures and he would tell us exactly what it is we need to be praying.
Yeah.
So everything we prayed was in alignment with the word of God. You want to know the easiest way to pray? Just pray the word of God.
That's it.
You got to pray the word of God. The easiest way, you know, people say, I just don't know what to pray. You know, you call on somebody to pray, like, what's that movie on Glory? I ain't never prayed before, you know. But you, all you gotta do is you just pray the word of God. This is your prayer book right here.
Yeah.
That's it.
This is your prayer book. This is your, like I told y'all, this is the instruction manual. This is your instruction manual for prayer also. This, I mean, of course, overall it's your instruction manual for life, but the word of God is also your instruction manual for prayer. So I got to make sure that when I'm praying, I am praying according to the word of God. Now, so when I say, is it okay to pray for money? Is it okay to pray for prosperity? Of course it is. Yes, it is okay to pray for money because the word of God says that my God shall supply all your needs.
Yeah.
According to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. So if I want prosperity, I say, Father, I thank you that you supply all my needs according to your riches in glory by Christ Jesus. That's an example of praying the word of God. Amen. And if you're sick in your body, all you got to do is say, he was wounded. Lord, I thank you that you were wounded for my transgressions. You were bruised for my iniquity, and the chastisement of our peace was upon you, and by your stripes I'm healed. What am I doing? I'm praying the word of God.
Yeah.
Amen. I'm not praying something, some other crazy prayer.
Yeah.
Amen. I'm not praying according to a self-help book, but I'm praying according to God's word. Amen.
Amen.
And as you read, and then let me say this, before I move on. Now, in order to pray the word, you got to
know the word.
No.
Come on here.
You got to know the word. You got to read the, how do you, you know, and let me say this, let me tell you this, you know, and that when it comes to knowing the word, that does not mean I just pick my Bible up on Sunday morning when it's time to go to church.
Yeah.
That's not what that means. That does not mean, okay, well, yeah, I pick my Bible on Sunday, yeah, because Sunday, that's worship day, or on Tuesday night or Wednesday night or whatever Bible study is. That's not picking. No, you got to be in the word every single day. Even if you just read one scripture, we've got to be in the word every single day. I'm not telling you to read the whole all the numbers in the Psalms in one day. That's not what I'm saying. But you need to have some kind of word going on the inside of you every single day, because you eat every day, don't you? We eat. Many of us, we exercise to keep our bodies healthy. Don't you think your spiritual life is just as important as your physical life? I got to get in this word.
Yes,
amen. And you can't always expect for the pastor, the preacher, or the Bible teacher to put the word in you all the time, because you can go in there and read it for yourself. Now, you do need someone in your life who can teach you to rightly divide the word, which is what I'm doing right now. But at the same time, you ought to be able to pick this thing up for yourself and know exactly what it says.
Yes,
amen. Many of us, you know, the only scripture many of us know is Jesus wept. We know that. In the 23rd Psalm. Everybody know 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall. You learned that in vacation Bible school. But is that all the scripture you know? Is that all the words you, if all the words you got in you is Jesus wept, baby, you in trouble. If that's all the words you got. If all the words you got in you is the 23rd Psalm, you in trouble. Now, the 23rd Psalm will carry you through a lot of stuff now. Don't get me wrong. It'll carry you through some stuff, but you got to know more than the 23rd Psalm. You got to know that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but are mighty through God in the pulling down of strongholds. You got to know things like that. You got to know that, oh, watch this. You got to know that the Bible says, bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house. And then he went on and said, and I will prove you, I will open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing. You got to have more word in you. Can you say amen? And you, and when you have the word in you, you can pray, but not only just pray, but you can pray right. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Let me move on here, because I can teach a whole sermon on that. Amen. So I'm going to challenge you. Next time you're praying, when you're praying and when you're meditating on the scripture, you need to ask yourself this question. How should I pray in accordance to what I'm reading? How should I pray in accordance to what I'm reading? So if I'm meditating on a particular scripture, I need to ask myself the question, okay, this is good. Now, God, how should I pray according to what I just read? Because I guarantee you, you know, I don't know if you're like me, when you go to a particular scripture, a lot of times God will take you to a scripture that's actually talking about what you're dealing with at that very moment. Do you not know that? There are times when you go into God's word and he'll take you right to a scripture that deals with everything you're going through. And all I know is, okay, God, you had me read this. So now I kind of see what I need to pray for. And once again, your prayer book is right here. This is your instruction, man. This is your guide right here. Because all you got to do is pray exactly what the word said is what you meditated on. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Now let me move on here. So I pray in accordance to his will. I ask according to his will. And I ask according to his word. But watch this. I also ask according to my faith. I ask according to my faith. Verse 15 says, and if we know that he hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have the petitions of him, that we ask of him. Now, we know that we have the petitions. That means that evidently we know that we shall have the things we ask for, or that the prayer will be answered. Okay, that's where my faith comes in. Because it does no good to pray and not believe that God's going to do what you ask him to do, as long as you're praying according to his will and according to his word. Y'all see how this thing works together? So as long as I'm asking according to his will and I'm asking according to his word, then I know that when I ask him, I know I need to put my faith into action. And just like the song that Jamal just finished saying, knowing that God is going to do exactly what he said he was going to do.
Yeah.
Amen. So I have to ask according to my faith. And our prayers should also be driven by faith. And again, I tell you all the time, what is faith? Faith is doing what you say that you believe. Let me say it again. Faith is doing what you say that you believe. Okay, so I got faith. So if I have faith, if I'm praying for healing, I should expect healing. If I'm praying for deliverance, I should expect deliverance. If I'm praying for prosperity, I should expect prosperity. If I'm praying for a job, I should expect a job. If I'm praying for a new car, I should expect a new car. If I'm praying for a home, I should expect a new home. So everything I prayed for, I should expect that God is going to fulfill exactly what he promised. So I'm praying. So I'm praying according to my faith. So right here, I'm praying with expectation. Because when I pray with expectation, then I will go move from expectation to experience. Y'all missed that. I'm moving now. See, I was praying with expectation. So I'm expecting God to do what I've asked him to do, because I made sure I followed his word. I followed what he told me to do. I'm in line with his will. So now I'm expecting God to do something. Can you say amen? Amen. And let me say this. God is not a cosmic genie. He's not a cosmic genie. You can't just go and rub a lamp or rub your Bible and you ain't picked it up. You don't know nothing in it. Nothing in it. Your Bible just sitting on your dashboard in your car. And you can't get to work and say, Lord, bless me with a promotion. Is that in God's will? Amen. You know, it's one thing to pray in faith, but it's another thing to pray a bunch of foolishness. See, that's foolishness. That's foolishness when you're praying stuff that really doesn't even have anything to do with what God has already told you to do. And really, you and God ain't had no kind of conversations about it before. But as time goes on, and as you're meditating, and as you're praying, and as you're believing God to do things that you need him to do, and you're expecting it, then, like I said before, that's when the experience comes in. And what I'm trying to move us to, I'm almost done here, but what I'm trying to move us to here is that, many times we talk about expectation. Expectation, expectation, expectation. Now, a part of this spiritual maturity process that we're going to be dealing with this year is what I'm trying to do. And I church theme. God gave me this church theme. I hate I didn't give it the first Sunday in January, but God didn't give me to the first Sunday in January. But our church theme for this year is going to be moving from expectation to experience. Moving from expectation. See, I changed the signatures on my emails and everything. I used to have moving from great to greater, but God said, it's time to kind of beef that up a little bit. Now you're going to move from expectation to experience. Amen. Because many of us, we need an experience from God. We need for God to work on our behalf. But the thing you got to remember is we got to do our part. We got to do our part. And that's why prayer is so important in the life of a believer, because first of all, like I said, you pray, you got to pray with passion, pray with persistence. You have to know what you're praying. You know how to pray. You need to ask according to his will, ask according to his word, ask according to our faith. We know that because that's why we designed these messages, for prayer to be the first thing we dealt with, because if that prayer life ain't right, Jamal, right. Nothing else is gonna fall into place. See, many times we want to do things backwards. Amen. Even that's in your personal life. Good and well that when you first graduate from college, unless you got a whole bunch of money saved up, you don't go buy just the biggest house you can get. Sometimes it takes steps. You got to grow into that thing. Amen. And sometimes you got to, live with mom and dad for a little while, save up some money. Sometimes you can go get you a nice little one-bedroom, get what you can afford, a one-bedroom apartment, just a simple economy car, just things to kind of just help you along. Then you can step up. See, I can't talk to you about prosperity until we get this prayer thing right. And I'm going to tell you what I'm talking about. I may mention this earlier. You can't expect to pray for God to bless your finances and you not giving. See, y'all saying amen. Don't nobody say they don't like it when we talk about giving. And y'all, and I'm going to tell y'all this because in this, and you really, and again, I didn't see a lot of things until I started pastoring. You know, and again, next month, the Lord says, well, in March, the Lord says, we'll be doing this thing for 3 years now. Amen. And I thank God he's kept us for 3 years. But in these short 3 years, God taught me a lot of stuff, not just about y'all. He taught me a lot of stuff about me. Because many times, you know, we pray, well, like, oh God, you know, we want you to open up the windows of heaven. Lord, I need prosperity in my life. Lord, I need all these things to take place. Lord, my, you know, baby need a pair of shoes. Got a gas bill due. All the, you know, telephone disconnect, waiting on my next paycheck, all that kind. We praying all that stuff. But then when I go back and look at my giving records, ouch. It's like, okay, God, I'm going to have to step it up in this area. Because, I mean, you know, and God dealt with me, y'all. He dealt with me on this thing about, even with prayer. Why are you asking me for stuff and you not doing your part? Hello, somebody. Why are you asking me to do this, that, and other for you? You're not doing your part. You know, and I almost, and y'all, and I, you know, as a pastor, yes. I mean, I believe in tithing. I believe in giving. You know, and I think I was pretty decent on my tithe. I really do. But I looked for it, so I was like, you know what? My giving, that's giving above the tithe, is not where it needs to be. Because this amount, I told my wife, I said, this amount, because we were doing the statements last night. I was like, this amount don't look right. But then I went through the envelopes, went through the checkbook and everything, like, no, Reverend, no, that's how much y'all gave this year. It's a good amount, but could you have done more? I told y'all, this is a learning process. We are all in this thing together. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Amen. I told y'all when you first came to this church, I never claimed to have it all together. You know, my wife, we don't claim to have it all together. We're all learning this thing together. But I know over our years of experience, God has taught us some things, and we want to use those things to bless you. I'm just trying to help God's people to grow up so we can be blessed. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Amen. And let me close this thing by saying this, because our spiritual growth should involve a deepening of our prayer lives. And when I pray according to the will of God, it involves a deepening of God's love, of my love for God, rather, and his will and his ways. So what I need to do, instead of asking God, you know, telling God what I want, I need to ask God, God, what do you want?
Yeah.
Let me say it again. When I say, you know, instead of saying, God, I won't, I won't, I won't, I won't, give me, give me, give me, give me, I need, I need, I need.
Yeah.
God, what do you want? It's, you know, and it's amazing how in church nowadays we become more consumers and not producers. Because the first thing people do when they want to join this church, they come ask me, they ask my wife, do y'all have a children's ministry? Do y'all have a mission ministry? Do y'all have this? Do you have a benevolence committee? What do y'all, you know, do y'all help people pay their light bills, their water bills, their gas bills? Hello, somebody. Y'all talk back to me if you can. Amen. But, why not ask, you know, John F. Kennedy say? Don't ask what you can do for your country. Don't ask what your country can do for you, but ask what for you can do for your country. My thing is, you know, stop telling God, asking God, you know, to do stuff for you. What can you do for him? Now, I mean, first of all, God doesn't need us to do anything. Let me go on and get that straight now. But there are some things he requires of. Okay, all right, and it's not just in giving. What about serving in the body of Christ? You know, can I go and can I go and witness to somebody? Can I go and just pray for somebody? Can I go and can I help the greeters ministry? Do they need help in the children's ministry? What can be done? Pastor, is there anything? Do y'all need me to help with some administrative work around the church? What, Lord, what can we do for you? What can we do for your kingdom?
Amen.
Because that's what it's all about. It's all about the kingdom. And if we're going to grow up and be spiritually mature, then our prayers need to be we need to not be so self-centered with our prayers, but we need to be more Christ-centered and say, okay, God, here I am before you. Lord, first of all, I thank you just for all that you've done for me, but God, I just need to know, what can I do for you?
Yeah.
Amen. We need to stop being consumers all the time. Amen. And work and focus on being producers. Amen. Amen. So we want our prayers always to be in alignment with God's will, We want them to be in alignment with his word. And we also want our prayers to be prayed. And whatever we ask God for, we need to ask according to our faith. Can you say amen? Amen. Amen. Y'all give God a hand clap of praise. Amen. Amen. That is our message for today. Amen. As the music plays softly, I want to just take this opportunity to